drawing of the machine elements and simple parts. 1. Learning objectives. At the end of this topic, you will be able to know the understanding of sectioning, describe the methods of dimensioning. Outcomes. By the end of this topic, you will be able to achieve an understanding of formal ways of presenting a part to be manufactured in detail. Dimensioning in engineering drawings provides an exact definition of the geometry approximated by the geometry entities. Sections. This chapter will deal with sectioning of machine parts. Types of sections. Sectional view of parts. Parts usually not sectioned. Types of sections. Why is sectioning of parts required? The external view of the part reveals only external features. There could be some hidden features which require sectioning. In order to view the inner features, the object is imagined to be cut by a cutting plane. The image is divided along two sectional planes. One is XX and another is YY. XX sectional view shows the hidden features in the vertical view of the image. YY sectional view shows the horizontal view of the image. Sectional views of parts. Full section. A sectional view is obtained by assuming that the object is completely cut by a plane. With such full section of part, the internal details can be revealed clearly. Consider a rectangular object with hollow projection on the top. Imagine a plane that cuts vertically through the center of the object. In order to reveal hidden features clearly, it may be necessary to present views of the part after sectioning. The region through which the section plane passes is known as hatched. Hatching is drawing inclined fine lines in the section region. Distinctive patterns are used for adjoining parts for easily distinguishing differing parts. The pattern of hatching is selected based on the type of material for the part. Half section. A half section is a view of an object showing one half of the view in section. The diagonal lines on the section drawing are used to indicate the area that has been cut. When one half of the part is selectively sectioned, the half section can reveal the details hidden and those available in normal views. Local section. Sometimes a local section to reveal the hidden detail is appropriate. The wavy outline corresponds to the sectioning plane. In order to make clear where the sectioning plane has been placed on the part, in the side view, the location of the sectioning plane is indicated by short, broken, thick lines, AA, as shown in the figure. The arrows indicate the direction of view. When the sectioning plane is made of more than a single plane, as shown on the right, the skewed or broken section plane is able to reveal more details. The local sectioning of some parts can indicate considerable amount of detail in simple ways. Such a case is shown in the diagram. The example shown here is a connecting rod. In some cases, the local section helps to minimize the number of views and yet show all necessary detail. Spokes and webs or wheels in section. A wheel with a solid web. A wheel with solid web and four ribs, which is sectioned, is shown here. The preferred method of identifying spokes in section for aligned and unaligned designs is shown here. Ribs and lugs in section. When the cutting plane passes through a rib parallel to its larger dimensions, the commonly accepted practice is to omit the section lining that shows the visible outline as if the cutting plane were just in front of the rib. Parts usually not sectioned. It is a convention that some parts, as well as some features of the parts, are never sectioned, that is, hatched. Basically, this improves the simplicity of the assembly shown in the section. Ribs. Casting of a pedestal type bearing journal with rib is shown here. Rib is not sectioned. Keys. Parallel key used in a shaft for fixing a pulley is shown. Key is not sectioned. Fasteners or screws. Example shows bolts or screws for joining blocks or plates are not sectioned. Rivets. All types of rivets used for joining plates are not sectioned. Rolling element. The balls or cylinder rollers in a bearing are always shown without sectioning. Methods of dimensioning. Basics of dimensioning. General rules for dimensioning. Features, holes and centers, curved and tapered features. Some basic rules. A machine part is composed of a bundle of geometrical features. These geometrical features are defined by the dimensions placed close to the feature. A geometrical feature is completely defined by a minimum set of dimensions. For example, a cylinder is defined uniquely by diameter or radius of base circle and length. Anything more is redundant. Once a feature is dimensioned in a view, it should not be dimensioned once again. In some cases, exception to this rule may be required. A particular dimension may have to be repeated and shown in another view for improved clarity. In such case, the redundant dimension should be placed in a bracket. Select the view where most of the dimensions defining one feature can be placed. If this is not possible, exceptions can be made. Functional dimensions. There are certain dimensions of the part which are directly linked to the function of the part. For example, outside diameter of a shaft. The torque transmitted is directly linked to this. The functional dimensions normally require to be prominently shown, and they may have to be toleranced to meet performance. For example, outside diameter of a shaft, non-functional dimensions. There are many dimensions of the part which are required as part of the geometry of the component and are not of critical nature. Auxiliary dimensions. These are dimensions which are placed in the drawing to provide additional information to facilitate manufacture or inspection. These are redundant dimensions and are placed inside a bracket. How to specify dimension of a geometrical feature? The dimension consists of a dimension text, which is the numerical value of the dimension expressed in millimeters. If the dimension contains decimal values, the decimal may be indicated by point or comma. The text is placed over the dimension line, or the baseline could be broken in the middle to place the text. The dimension text shows the dimension in millimeter. Dimension text is usually written in 0.25 mm thick line and about 2.5 or 3 mm letter height. Figure shows a bracket with various dimensions indicated. The tolerance applicable for the dimension is placed over this text. Dimension text and lines. The dimension line consists of dimension text. The dimension text shows the dimension, normally in millimeter, rounded off. The length unit is usually indicated in the title block. Dimension text is usually written in 0.25 mm or more thick line and about 3 mm height. If the dimension contains decimal value, the decimal may be indicated by point or comma. The text is placed over the dimension line, or the baseline could be broken in the middle to place the text. The dimension line is placed in the view of the part after some consideration. The placement should be ideal from understanding the geometrical feature or best from the view of manufacturing ease, or it should be of some functional significance. Dimension line is of the same length as the dimension of the geometrical feature shown in the view. Leader lines. Leader lines are placed starting from the geometrical feature, but with a break of 1 to 2 mm. Their length depends on where the dimension text can be placed on the drawing sheet or view. They extend 1 to 2 mm beyond dimension line. Part outline and arrows. Leader lines are normally drawn with a line thickness much finer than thickness used for part outline. For example, if the part is drawn with a line thickness of 0.20 or 0.25 mm, for leader line, 0.10 or 0.15 mm will be appropriate. The end of the dimension line is terminated with a pair of arrows, or sometimes with a slash or dot. The text showing the actual dimension may be placed in the middle, above or below the dimension line. It's usually placed by breaking the dimension line in the middle just enough to enter the dimension text. Where the space available is insufficient, the dimension text is placed over the extension of the dimension line. Dimension line is of the same length as the dimension of the geometrical feature given in the part drawing. If different, place a slash under the dimension text to draw attention. The end of the dimension line is terminated with a pair of arrows, or sometimes with a slash or dot. Arrow size is selected nearly same as the text size. Important consideration in dimensioning. The dimension line is placed in the view of the part after some consideration. The placement should be ideal from understanding the geometrical feature, or best from the point of view of ease of manufacturing, or it should have some functional significance. The text showing the actual dimension may be placed in the middle of the dimension line, either above or below the line. It may be placed by breaking the dimension line in the middle just enough to enter the dimension text. When the space available is insufficient, the dimension text is placed over the extension of the dimension line. Use a line thickness for text, same as for part outline. Crossing of dimension line should be avoided, except in rare cases. The dimension should be normally placed outside the part as a rule. However, in some instances, it is allowed to place a few dimensions inside the view of the part, either for clarity or to avoid too many views. When space is very narrow, dimension text is placed outside with the arrow reversed. Dimensioning of geometrical features. Diameter of circles. The dimension may refer to a shaft diameter or that of a hole. The dimension is preferably placed outside the part, but for large circles, exceptions can be made. For holes placed on a pitch circle, the dimension can be placed outside with leaders pointing to the feature. Diameter of shafts. The dimensions are preferably placed outside the part. The shaft diameter, steps or collars, and grooves for seating external circle are shown. Note that the groove size, width and diameter are placed in unconventional method due to space restriction. Diameter of counter board and counter sunk holes. The dimensioning can be placed using appropriate leaders. Diameter of spherical object. The dimension may be placed as shown. In some cases, the spherical feature may be indicated as SBH phi 30, SBH R 15. Example is knob on gear shift lever, fillet radii, castings, forgings, and many machined or molded parts, feature corner of fillet radii, chamfers, and beveled object. The dimension involves a distance X angle and is best shown as on the right. Dimensions of tapered object. The dimension for taper involves 1, 1 diameter, 2, taper angle, which can be shown as a ratio or angle. Note that the ratio is tan angle. Tan inverse of 1 by 10 is equal to 5 degree 43 minutes. Example, Morse taper, drill shank, forging or casting draft, lure, medical devices, etc. Dimensioning of castings. The cavity is formed in the sand mold with a pattern mimicking the shape and dimensions of the part. Molten metal, when poured through the runner, fills the cavity. The solidified metal is taken out of the mold and machined to give the finished part. Allowances should be given on surfaces which require machining. For hollow parts, a core is inserted. This requires a draft angle. Also, corners are given large fillet. Dimensioning of forgings. The cavity is sunk in two halves of die steel blocks. Hot metal bar or block is placed one over one half and is pressed with the other. Pressure could be exerted by dropping the top half or hydraulically. The cooled part has the form of the part and is machined to get the functional dimensions. Forgings are very strong on account of the favorable grain pattern in the metal. Dimensioning of fabricated and welded sub-assembly. Example of such construction could be frame for a machine. Hot rolled steel sheet is gas cut and edges are machined to require straightness and plate dimensions. Plates are positioned by tack welding. Final welding by manual metal arc welding. Type of weld joints, fillet and butt weld. Several type of weld beads can be produced, but from strength consideration, the fillet weld will be preferred whenever possible. Fillet welds join two surfaces at approximately right angles to each other. Butt welding is used to connect parts which are nearly parallel and don't overlap. The notation convention for weld is shown on the right. Summary. Let's summarize the topic. Full section of part reveals the internal details clearly. A machine part is composed of a bundle of geometrical features. Fillet welds join two surfaces at approximately right angles to each other. Butt welding is used to connect parts which are nearly parallel and don't overlap.